What's going on, everyone? Dougie here. Welcome to another course vlog. Today I'm coming from Reunion Country Club. It's a really, really nice course. Haven't played it before. It's a little bit of a drive from Atlanta, but I'm excited to bring you along. I'm gonna do a little course vlog, mostly golf. Not gonna talk a bunch, but I don't know if I can resist talking and do a full pure golf course vlog. So welcome to the video. If you're new, make sure to hit that red subscribe button. Thanks for being here. I mean, how pure is this place? Morning golf, sun is rising, course looks so pure. It's rained a little bit, so it's a little wet, but I mean, come on, this is just lush. We have about 120, pin is back. I'm going sand wedge, I don't know if it's enough, but my cart's all the way over there, and I think I'm just gonna hit what I got. So I hit that fine. I mean, a little bit of a push, but it just wasn't the right club. And I kind of knew that going into it, but I just wanted to convince myself if I mashed it, I could get there. We're just barely on the green, so it's gonna be a long one. So after a great drive, I probably have about 250 yards. Don't know exactly. There's the pin. We're going for it. I've elected to hit a 5-wood. I can't see what's behind the green, but if I hit a 3-wood over the green, it could be in trouble. Anything in front of us we know is okay, so we're going 5-wood. Very good miss there. Missed the green short and right. But again, everything's in front of us. We know we're in good shape. That was the right club from about 250. I just flared it out a little bit right. Now we got the opportunity to get up and down to do something special here. Get a birdie and look at this. Chipping over the sand trap. The sun's coming up. I mean, come on. This is what golf is all about here. Check out these little steps into the bunker. I kind of wish that I'd hit it in the bunker because that looks pretty pure right there, not gonna lie. All right, we gotta dial in the 60 degree here, try to fillet one over the bunker, trickle it up to the hole. I mean, really good check there, really good spin. I just, you know, pulled it five, seven feet, but really, really happy with the contact there. That was just a well-executed game plan. I don't know what to say. I mean, gotta just tip my cap to myself there. Just felt so good to execute the game plan, the way we drew it up. You know, played that hole smart, played everything in front of us, trusted our short game, hit the 60 degree and just, sorry about that noise back there, just nipped it tight and executed on the putt. So that's why we put in the hard work, to enjoy moments like that. Look at this par four. Beautiful, 415 yards from the tips, which is where we're playing back here. Beautiful course. First time out here at Reunion Country Club. I definitely want to come back. And once I know where to hit the ball, when I have a little bit more time, can kind of just enjoy being out here. Really beautiful track. Really pleased with how I'm driving the ball. Been making some swing changes lately. The driver's starting to click a little bit. I've always played a draw, now I'm playing a slight fade. Driver's starting to click, the irons, it's hit or miss. I either hit it dead pure, and I'll never apologize for hitting it too pure, or comes off a smidge fat. Course conditions are very pristine, and I'm in great shape right out there, about 125, just past the 150 marker. We're looking to attack here. We got a pin that's front and it's left.
Let's go.
This is what we're looking at here. Again, we're doing cart path only, no yardages, no rangefinder, pretty much eyeballing it, finding the 150 stake. So look at that pin. Look how tucked that is left. Do I go right at the pin or do I go middle? Maybe middle with a little draw. How about that? Over the green, over the entire green. How is that possible? 125, 130. You know what? I will never apologize for hitting a two pure, but I should get a rangefinder. That might help. So thankfully, we just nestled right there behind the green. Uphill lie. Pretty good look here to get up and down. But again, I mean, we got a hazard behind the green. Anything front of the green, you can see it's in fairway. So it kind of goes back to what I was saying. You want to miss in front of you. You're kind of in between clubs. But anyway, gave it a run. Now we got to get up and down. You know, I just caught that hill a little bit, didn't hit my landing spot, and that really cost me. Just kind of slowed down and stopped. It's the opposite with chipping. Don't want to leave anything short with chipping. Want to give it a run, get it to the hole. If anything, roll it a little past. Okay, not ideal, but we do have a shot. We can get it back in play. It's a little puncheroo. Okay, I have no idea the yardage. Could be 220, could be 270. We'll see. There's water to the right of the green. It's a blind shot. What could possibly go wrong? I hit that bad boy right on the screws. Not sure where it ended up, but it looked like I carried the water. There's a lot of questions remaining. Where am I? I mean, I didn't see a splash. I was going to the right side of the pin with a three wood that was cutting. It's not on the green. Is it over the green? Is it in the hazard? This is a really hard green to hit, much less with a three wood off of a left to right sloper from 240. So I don't know. I don't know if we're okay. Really hit that shot well, but gotta keep moving on. Pretty good. Not a bad recovery shot there, but I'm still puzzled. I just don't get it. I hit that three wood so well. I don't know what happened. I mean, it didn't splash. If it went over, I didn't quite find it, but I only had like 20 seconds to look for it, so. Kind of a bad break there. Again, not knowing whether it was 240, 210, or 270 kind of hurt me. That is an all-world save. Incredible resilience. Again, gotta just tip my hat to myself there. Really good job not getting flustered. People behind me trying to step on my ankles. I'm hitting Sergio Garcia, three wood running kick shots that are somehow not findable, but we managed to get out of there. What was that, a bogey maybe? Not bad. That putt right there, oh my gosh, I hit it so, so pure. The roll was looking good. I knew it wasn't going to break as much as the slope looked like it was. I thought we had it, but if you're gonna miss a putt and roll it by 2 feet, burning edges, that means you're doing something right. So I'm gonna take the positive from that. Now we got a nice par five right here. Let's let it rip. There's a lot of people jibber jabbering on TikTok about me holding my follow through. People saying, what are you, a tour pro? Is your name on your bag? I mean, you look like a statue out there holding your follow through. You know what I gotta say to that? That one was for you. Okay, if anything, I'm gonna hold my follow through even more now. Beautiful tee shot here on the par five. Look at this view we got at the green. Pin is sitting front. I have no idea how far we are. It looks like the 150 stake is probably 80 yards. I'd guess 230, maybe 215 to the front. That's my guesstimation. See if we can get it on the green in two. Okay, a little bit blocky there. Hopefully I'm not in any trouble, just out to the right. Here we are, a little bit long to the right, like I was thinking. Honestly, not a great spot to be. I mean, look at this. Pin's tucked over there, we got a hill over there. Not sure what the play is. You know, all in all there, what we learned from that hole is I had about 220 out, grabbed a 3-iron. I thought it might be too much. Maybe I should go 4. But no, why wouldn't we listen to our instincts? Why? So I ended up hitting it past the green, left myself a bad angle coming in. Lesson learned, trust your instinct. Just trust it. Go with the number, the club that you think, the first club that comes to mind, because that's usually more often than not right. Here we have a 455 yard par 4 from the tips. That's tough. We got a boom one out there with the D stick to have a good chance at par in this hole. Wow. I can tell you, this hole's not gonna play that long anymore. Not after that swing. Absolutely hit it on the screws with a draw. The slope looks like it goes right to left. I feel like this just became a birdie hole. Maybe it was a bogey hole. We just flipped the script after that swing. We're sitting picture perfect here. I think I drew it off the slope a little bit, just played it to perfection. All those TikTokers can you know what after that one. Look at this. We got about 165, 170, pins middle. I'm thinking maybe hard 8 because we're a little downwind. I think that should be enough. Otherwise, smooth 7. Well, we're back to a bogey hole. Heck, we might even be a double bogey hole. That thing just drew off the slope, missed the green to the left. Looked like it tumbled down there. Hopefully it didn't go in the hazard. Literally any other miss would have been fine. We missed it left, we tumbled down. But oh wait, there's our ball. We got a chance. What a crazy hole. The turntables kept turning. We went from birdie par hole after the tee shot to bogey hole to maybe par, and then man, started putting a line on my ball, trying out new things on the putting green. Trusted the line there, cured the stroke, par on a 455 yard par 4. Feeling pretty good about that. So before we start feeling too good, we now have a par 3 behind us, playing 217 yards. The card says 222, the pin is back. It's playing all at 222. Look at this stunning beauty of a par 3. Look at this, all carry, pin is back. 220 would get us probably to the middle. Pin's probably more like 229. Wow. I got a 4-iron, let's see how we do here. Wow, wow. That is playing all of 229. Hit that a little bit thin, a little weak, and it caught the slope and rolled all the way down. Little update on this monstrosity of a par 3. I caught the slope right here, tumbled back down there. We got a long pitch, a lot of green to work with. Let's see what we can do. Been working a little bit on the bump and run game. I really need to bump and run it well here. got about 85 feet of green to work with. So got to get it on the front of the green. Still deciding, maybe an 8-iron I think is what I'm going to go with. Just let it coast all the way up. Not ideal to leave it right there, but it's another opportunity to work on our short game. This is kind of where the cream rises to the top. Are you a mid handicapper? Are you a high handicapper? Or are you low type of scratch almost player? This is where the butter gets made here. Well, you know, that's how the butter is made. The chip was great, you know, left myself a 5-footer maybe, kind of slick a little down the hill, but not a ton of movement, you know, a little left to right. That's where the butter gets made, right? You look at making a 5 there versus a 4. You think, oh, it's just one stroke. Multiply that over 18 holes. That's the difference between shooting even par and shooting a 90, right? Getting those up and down opportunities, converting those. So it's okay. I mean, the chipping was there. The putt, I think I slightly pushed it, and that's enough right there to get the ball offline and miss the hole. So that's where the butter's made. I mean, trying to move down towards scratch, like have to be higher make percentages inside 8 feet, point blank, period. The par threes out at Reunion Country Club are absolutely gorgeous. Let's go ahead and see if we can get in attack mode. I feel like we've been in defensive mode a little bit, missing greens, dinking and dunking, having to get up and down, make long putts for par. How about sticking one? How about getting aggressive? Let's go. Just a hair fat there. It's pretty frustrating. I feel like I'm just really close to just pure strikes and a lot of good look at birdies. And instead I'm kind of, as I've been saying, trying to grind a little bit, but gotta understand it in context. I mean, I've been making some swing changes lately, especially on the irons, a little bit of weight transfer, thinking about loading on my left leg, weight on the left leg, impact position with that forward shaft lean. So I'm coming down a little steeper and catching a little fat, but it's gonna take some time to kind of groove in the changes. And when I'm catching it pure, it just feels so good. So can't get too frustrated. Got to just stick to the process. I mean, also the way that I'm thinking about it is I want to be able to depend upon my short game to bail me out. If I have a day where I'm not driving the ball well or I'm not hitting greens, I don't want that to be kind of a terrible day on the course. I want to be able to still score well because of my short game, rely on the short game. So yeah, I'm not striking my irons well, I'm missing greens. But this is really important to kind of focus on leaning into that short game as a vital part, because you don't want to be, you know, scoring low if you're really striking the ball well. And if you have an off day, 10 strokes higher. I want to be consistent. And to get that, achieve that consistency, it starts with the short game. And then no matter how I'm ball striking, you know, no matter how I'm hitting the ball, I want to know, hey, I can go out there and play well and compete and still score well because of my short game. That being said, you know it. This is where the butter is made. We're just short of the green here in the fairway. Come on, let's go. Let's make some butter. held the follow through a little bit long there. That was for all the little jibber jabbers, all the people on TikTok, keyboard warriors, telling me that I think I'm a professional golfer. You know what? I'm just gonna keep holding the follow through. Keep holding it, especially when I hit it pure. Just keep holding it and just watch it like a hawk. Just enjoy every second of watching that ball split the fairway. What I was saying earlier is that when you miss greens, that's where the butter's made, getting up and down. Well, you know what? Part two of where the butter is made. When you get looks at birdie, especially inside 20 feet, okay? That's where people separate themselves. I don't know what's going on behind me. We got people building houses back here, but that's where people separate themselves. That's where I'm trying to separate myself right here, right now, the pure stroke. That is where the butter is made. Wow, it just felt so good. I mean, just felt so good. We came out here to make some butter. We wanted to start churning, and we did. We did right there. Great opportunity, great capitalization right there. Just very, very pleased. All right, let's go make some more butter. That's either going to be out of bounds left, or I'm sitting in and I just cut the corner. I don't know. It's an aggressive line. I drew it more than I'd wanted to, but it looked like it caught the top shelf. So it depends what kind of bounce I got. So fortunately I stayed up. There's a little more room over here than I thought. Bad news is because I'm on the left side, there's no look at the green. Probably would be about 260, 275 anyway, but green's like over here. So I'm just gonna hit a pitching wedge and just kind of fillet one up there, give myself a nice angle in. You know, it's tough to hit a layup shot on a par five. It's tough to hit a perfect layup shot. I might have just done it. That was about as perfect of a shot as I possibly could have hit. Hit a pitching wedge, about three quarter swing. I drew it with the wind, saw it bounce. I mean, that was about picture perfect. You should be looking mint. A1 position. Wow, this green's pretty. The bunkering out here is awesome. This is not a course I would want to walk. It's car path only today. Pretty hilly, kind of some long drives between tee boxes. So I'd definitely recommend taking a cart if you're out here. Okay, like I was saying, perfect layup. And now we got this tasty little approach shot into the par five, our last hole out here. Wow, I might even have to go set up the camera behind the hole because this one is going to be tight. You know, I preach a lot of patience, staying patient on the golf course, learning from our shots as we're playing the round. This was case in point, okay? We talked about staying patient, talked about learning from opportunities, talked about making butter. There, we just did that. It was just such a fun hole to play. I mean, that sand wedge, glad I set the camera up behind it because man, I was in between clubs. I went with the longer club, the sand wedge there, took a little bit off of it, controlled the spin and trajectory, and just kind of played it to perfection. It actually helped that I walked up to the green because I could see that little ridge behind the hole. So I was like, hey, you can get to that ridge. It's gonna come back. It's exactly what we did. We bounced, rolled up to the ridge, drifted back. That putt was dicey, okay? The putt was dicey. Had to trust my line, trust my stroke. And man, we just made some butter. So thank you so much for watching this video from Reunion Country Club. If you've watched to this point, I appreciate it. Like, drop a comment down below. Drop a comment about how we made some butter in this video. Had a lot of fun. ended birdie. We'll see you next time. Golf Fan signing out. Dougie, peace.